The Senate will come to order. I ask everyone present to please rise and recite the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Okay. In the absence of clergy, let us bow our heads in a moment of silence, reflection, or prayer. Reading of the journal.
In Senate, Wednesday, March 24, 2021, the Senate met pursuant to adjournment. Journal of Tuesday, March 23, 2021, was read and approved. On motion, the Senate adjourned.
Without objection, the journal stands approved as read. Presentation of petitions, messages from the Assembly, messages from the Governor, reports of standing committees, reports of select committees, communication and reports from state officers, motions and resolutions. Senator Gianaris.
Thank you, Madam President. On behalf of Senator Salazar, on page 16, I offer the following amendments to calendar 363, Senate 3291, and ask that said bill retain its place on the third reading calendar.
The amendment is received, and the bill should retain its place in the third reading calendar.
Let's take up the reading of the calendar.
The Secretary will read.
Calendar number 117, Senate 1556 by Senator Parker, an act to amend the public service law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Krueger, or Stewart Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 117, voted in the negative, Senator Akshar, aye 62, nays 1.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 126, Senate print 346 by Senator Kaplan, an act to amend the tax law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect on the 1st of January.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Krueger, or Stewart Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 126, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Akshar, Gallivan, Griffo, Helming, Lanza, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Rath, and Steck. Ayes 51, nays 10.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 163, Senate print 1317 by Senator Gorin, an act to amend the real property tax law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Aye 61.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 237, Senate print 355 by Senator Hoyman, an act to amend the environmental conservation law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect on the 180th day of the shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Krueger, or Stewart Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 237, those voting in the negative are Senators Akshar and Tedisco. Ayes 59, nays 2.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 359, Senate print 3866 by Senator Kennedy, an act to amend the public health law.
Read the last section.
Section 4, this act shall take effect on the 1st of January.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Krueger, or Stewart Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 61.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 510, Senate print 4201A by Senator Savino, an act to amend the civil service law.
Laid aside.
Calendar number 532, Senate print 5304 by Senator Reichlin Melnick, an act to amend the state finance law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Krueger, or Stewart Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 532, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Ort and Palumbo. Ayes 59, nays 2.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 584, Senate print 4092 by Senator Hinchey, an act to amend the environmental conservation law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 61.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 587, Senate print 4596 by Senator Kaminsky, an act to amend the environmental conservation law.
Read the last section.
Section six, this act shall take effect on the 60th day after shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 587, those senators voted in a negative are Senators Gallivan, Griffo, Lanza, Martucci, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Rath, Ritchie, Steck, and Tedisco. Ayes 50, nays 11.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 594, Senate Print 4738 by Senator Ramos, an act to amend the labor law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 594, voted in a negative, Senator Griffo. Ayes 60, nays 1.
The bill is passed. Senator Giannaris, that completes the reading of today's calendar.
Thank you, Madam President. Can we move on to the controversial calendar, please?
The Secretary will ring the bell. The Secretary will read.
Calendar number 510, Senate Print 4201A by Senator Savino, an act to amend the civil service law.
Senator Lanza, why do you rise?
Madam President, I believe there's an amendment at the desk. I waive the reading of that amendment and ask that Senator Tedisco be recognized.
Thank you, Senator Lanza. Upon review of the amendment, in accordance to Rule 6, Section 4B, I rule it non-germane and out of order at this time.
Accordingly, Madam President, I appeal the ruling of the Chair and ask that Senator Tedisco be recognized.
The appeal has been made and recognized, and Senator Tedisco may be heard. Senator Tedisco.
Thank you, Madam President. I ask that you rule germane this amendment to fully repeal the governor's emergency powers, as I believe it is especially relevant to this bill and the historic significance of this day, March 25th, which sadly has become a new day of infamy in New York State. Exactly 1 year ago today, thanks to his vast pandemic emergency powers, which he still enjoys, the governor issued an executive order that mandated that COVID-positive patients be placed into nursing homes. We've come to understand that it was through the governor's tragic actions that many of our 15,000 nursing home residents died from coronavirus. Earlier this morning, I joined several of my colleagues and the families of those nursing home residents who lost their lives to commemorate this sad occasion and call for the state to set aside this date moving forward as a day of solemn reflection in New York State for all those souls who needlessly lost lives. We remember that every life lost was more than just a statistic. These individuals were someone's spouse, parent, grandparent, and sibling, and they deserve justice. Today, I'm wearing this shamrock pin given to me by my constituent, Dan Mathias of Clifton Park in the 49th Senate District, in honor of his mother, Doris, who lost her life to COVID-19 while in a Buffalo area nursing home. For close to a year, the Cuomo administration denied its March 25th executive order had any substantial impact in spreading the virus in our nursing homes as to what the governor himself defined as a wildfire through dry grass. The governor and his staff conspired to cover this data up because it didn't fit with the false narrative in his book that he was Andrew Cuomo, the COVID slayer, when now we know he was Andrew Cuomo, the COVID purveyor. It wasn't until the Attorney General issued a scathing report last month, pulling back the veil of secrecy from the Cuomo administration, finding there was a 50% undercount of the total number of those who got the contagion in a nursing home and died, and those who got it and died in the hospital. After the Attorney General's bombshell report was released, Justice Kimberly O'Connor made a judgment on a lawsuit by myself and the Empire Center, saying the Cuomo administration violated the open government law and ordered the full nursing home data be publicly released. Now that the Cuomo administration is the subject of a federal criminal investigation by the FBI and U.S. Attorney's Office in Brooklyn, for its handling of the nursing home cover-up. We must ensure that a terrible tragedy like this never happens again. We also need an independent bipartisan state commission with subpoena power that I am sponsoring with Assemblyman Ron Kim to fully investigate the nursing home deaths, to bring closure to the families of loved ones who lost their lives, and learn what happened so we can be prepared for future pandemics. We also need to create a penalty for violating New York's open government and freedom of information law. Not just a violation, not just a slap on the wrist. Earlier this month, the Senate majority had a chance to stand up to this governor and fully restore the legislature's role as an equal branch of government by fully repealing the governor's emperor-like emergency powers. Unfortunately, I and many others believe they did not do so and instead passed a full repeal bill that actually extended the governor's emergency powers indefinitely. What's chilling is that the governor still has the power to issue a new executive order to resend COVID-positive patients back into nursing homes and repeat the terrible tragedy he caused 1 year ago. Because one of those 60 executive orders repealed April 11th, his March executive order to mandate that they be put into nursing homes, causing this tragedy. He can adjust or repeal any of those 60 executive orders he has in place, according to the bill that passed a week or so ago. Mr. President and my colleagues, excuse me, Ms. President, Madam President, let me get that right, and my colleagues, today as we reflect and remember the 15,000 lives lost, let's honor their memories and begin to seek justice for their families by fully revoking the governor's emergency powers. Madam President, I ask to appeal the ruling of the chair and that this amendment be ruled germane. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Tedesco. I want to remind the House that the vote is on the procedures of the House and the ruling of the chair. Those in favor of overruling the chair signify by saying aye.
By agreement, the entire minority will be recorded in the affirmative, Madam President.
Without objection, so ordered. Announce the results.
Ayes 20.
The ruling of the chair stands, and the bill in chief is before the House. The secretary will ring the... Are there any other senators wishing to be heard? Seeing and hearing none, debate is closed. The secretary will ring the bell. Read the last section.
Section 2, this action take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Senator Savino to explain her vote.
Thank you, Madam President. On March 18th of 2020, Governor Cuomo signed emergency legislation guaranteeing job protection and pay for New Yorkers who have been quarantined as a result of the novel coronavirus or COVID-19. At the time when the governor signed the bill, he said, "No one should have to make the impossible choice between losing their job or providing for their family and going to work, especially during this pandemic." At the time, we were just beginning to realize that we were on the brink of what would become the worst public health crisis that we would face in our lifetime. Within weeks, we would be shutting down our economy, restaurants, offices, retail, all non-essential businesses, schools, universities, shifting as many as possible to remote work and learning. For some, the idea of remote work is impossible. Our essential workforce, our first responders, police, fire, healthcare, and corrections just cannot do it by broadband. We place new requirements on private employers to demand that they protect their workforce and not punish them when they were forced to quarantine or take time due to exposure to COVID-19. We adopted rules by here in the state of New York. We told private employers how they had to treat their employees to protect them and their paychecks. So it was shocking to find out that the New York City Department of Corrections was actually punishing their own employees for following the rules that we adopted right here in the state of New York. Since last March, according to the Board of Corrections in the city of New York, 1,400 officers and staff have tested positive to COVID-19. 8 members have succumbed to the disease. 893 correction officers who tested positive and were forced to utilize their sick time to comply with the requirements that were set out by the Department of Health were declared to be chronically absent by the Department of Corrections in the city of New York. This determination is considered an adverse disciplinary action that goes into effect after an officer has missed 11 days of work. 11 days of work. That determination can have an impact on their pay, promotion, hours, and makes many of them vulnerable to potential layoffs. The legislation that we are passing here today sends a clear message to not only the New York City Department of Corrections, but to all public employers, that we will not tolerate this type of punitive action against employees who show up and follow the laws and the rules that we write. Thank you, Madam President.
Senator Savina, to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the result.
Ayes 62.
The bill is passed. Senator Gianaris, that completes the reading of the controversial calendar.
Madam President, I have another motion on behalf of Senator Parker. I wish to call up Senate 1453A, recalled from the Assembly, which is now at the desk.
The Secretary will read.
Calendar number 116, Senate Print 1453A by Senator Parker, an act to amend the public service law.
The vote by which this bill was passed.
The Secretary will call the roll on reconsideration.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Cougar, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White. Aye, 62.
The bill is restored to its place on third reading calendar.
I offer the following amendments.
The amendments are received.
Is there any further business at the desk?
There is no further business at the desk.
I move to adjourn until Tuesday, March 30th at 3 p.m., intervening days being legislative days.
On motion, the Senate stands adjourned until Tuesday, March 30th at 3 p.m., intervening days being legislative days.